Okay, so the first thing is the eye is pretty much like centered. So right in the center of your piece, and I did a little sketch here to show you guys. So yeah, just starting out with like the simple shapes. So you're going to start out with an oval shape kind of towards the middle of your composition. And super light sketch. So you should barely see these lines because it'll be easier for you to move it around. And then inside of that oval shape, you are going to do another oval. This one's skinny and tall. So that would be the pupil right here. And then we are going to do another oval. And it's going to be the highlight in the eye. Do you guys have experience drawing eyes? You can like raise your hand if you do. Yeah, cool. Yeah, I mean, there's so many different ways to approach it. You could spend like a whole lifetime just drawing eyes. There's artists who only do that. But it's cool because it's like that saying, you know, the eyes are the window to the soul. So there's so much detail when you look deeply into someone's eyes. All right. So that's our eyeball. And now we are going to do our eyelid. So just to the left of that, you can start with a little curve line. And just notice how, you know, how lightly I'm pressing down, also how loose I am. You know, when I'm sketching, I'm just kind of moving my hand and, you know, allowing my lines to fluidly, like, go onto the paper. You don't have to worry about making them perfect. And then this isn't anatomically correct, but there's so many different like highlights in here and colors mixing because it's like this this look of this like woman's eye or someone's eye, it doesn't have to be a woman, I guess, with like glitter and lots of like different different sparkles. So you can go ahead and do a couple curve lines for these like bright white highlights. And then just connect that to the lower lid. Cool. So what we're doing is a lot of like artists will use blue as an undertone or an underpainting. You know, when you look at your hands, some of you may be able to see like the veins in your hands, and you know, our blood is, even though it comes out red when it's like oxidized, it's actually like blue inside. So like blue is a really good one for building up flesh. So a lot of artists will build it up from like blues, greens, like really thin layers, then to like more of your like fleshy tones. So that really changes depending on, you know, the skin tone. So next from the pupil here, you're gonna do a curve line curving down and over to the right side of the paper. And then you can do another one. So this is the upper eyelid, and this is the lower lid. So, we're not going to spend too much time on the sketch, because as you can tell, it's a pretty blurry image. And that's not just because of like the print quality, that's actually how the painting looks. And that's the quality that she wants to achieve. So the way that you can get that blur is we're going to fill in, these, like block out these areas of color just with the blue first. And then we can use, either our fingers, you can use, if you don't want to get your fingers dirty, you can use like a tissue. Or like a Kleenex, or if you even have your blending tool, your blending stomp, you can use that too. So, just starting, you can, start to map out the shapes you see here. So, curve line, curving off to the right, another curve going up. And these I just found from looking at my image here. So if you look closely, there's like this curve curving over to the side and then a darker underneath. And it's not blue, but we're gonna build up the tone in thin layers, just like our artist. Have this almost triangular shape over here. And then up here for the eyebrows, it's like this big, it's like a big kind of semicircle. And that I just kind of did really loosely using the flat side of my pencil and moving it back and forth. So I know we've gone over this before, but just a refresher, there's so many different ways that you can hold your pencil, and that really changes the effect you get. So, when I'm drawing, I'm holding it a little bit closer to the tip, and it's usually a little bit more pointed towards the ceiling, versus when I'm shading, I'm holding it really flat against the paper. And you can shade these areas in pretty quickly. I'll try to get a little more light for you guys. Is that better? Cool. Okay, so when you're done with that, you can go ahead and darken the value. So we have like the really light of value of the paper, this kind of medium tone value, and then this darker for the lash line. So from the pupil, I'm gonna bring my pencil over towards the left. And I'm going to add this little like curve. And and then it becomes an angle, so it comes to a point, curves back towards the inner corner of the eye. And I'm also just pressing down a little bit harder, so I'm like holding it more control and using more pressure. So you can tell the difference, like it's a really stark white on the left here and it's a little blurred here. So the way that I got that is I actually just used my blending tool. If you don't have this, this is basically just like a piece of paper like rolled up a million times, and you can use it to blend different, you know, pencil, and you can use it for a colored pencil too if you want. So I just went over this and I basically am moving the color around, but you can get the same effect by just using your finger. So, you know, just moving your color around to create that really light value on the side there. And it also just creates more of like a hazy, fuzzy kind of effect. So kind of like when we were doing the value for MC Escher. Oh, nice. I see your Pura Vida bracelet, Reed. My sister works for that company. So I have like a lifetime supply of Pura Vida bracelets. Okay, how are you guys doing so far? Good. It's a good time. You guys can hold up your pieces and then I can take a look at what you have so far. If you have any questions or anything. Nice, Lily looks good. For the eyebrow, see how far over the eyebrow ends? Like if I were to, you know, line this up, it's almost towards the end of this curved line here. So I think yours just needs to be moved over to the to your right more, but that's a quick fix. Yeah. How are you doing, Spirit? Good. Nice. Yeah, it looks good so far. And then, okay, yeah, and you have the eyebrow on there. Cool. Nice. Good. Okay. All right, are you ready for the next step, Reed? Yeah, can I see your drawing so far? Cool, nice. And then did you try kind of making it fuzzy by like running your finger over it? Yeah, you can like press down really hard for that part. Cool. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna pick up the pace now and just start like adding tons of color in. So I'm going to start out with the center of the piece, so the cooler colors. I also chose this piece because it has a good use of, you know, contrast in the cooler in the middle right here, you know, your like turquoise, greens, and then the warmer on the outside. So like these like reds, kind of purple, raspberry colors. So yeah, it's a great use of color theory too. So we can start out with the pupil. So when you look, you know, a lot of people think of the pupil as black, but you can also, you know, mix black, so get a dark tone that almost looks black. So to get that, I'm going to use, you know, back to our color star. I'm gonna use the violet blue. This one, I have Prismacolors if you have those too. Otherwise it's like a really dark purple. So you can go ahead, I'm just gonna put this to the side. Alright. And you're just going to go around your highlight. You wanna leave that white. I do have like a little tiny rim of blue on the inside of that. And then you can also, you know, outline your pupil here. Oh, it kind of looks like, it's reminding me of the shape of like a peacock's feather, especially the color too. Okay. And then this is super dark. So really bump up the pressure, like pressing down super hard, you know, getting that color on there. So talking about our element of art texture, you always want to, like, as artists, kind of think about what the texture would be like and what kind of mark making is going to achieve that texture. So I think that's why, like, you know, so many of my friends who are artists, like, have a love for so many different things, because it's like, as artists, you're gathering just so much information, and artists are so, like, especially realists, like people who are interested in capturing reality, are so intrigued by like so many different things, because they use that information that they take from like observing life around them and use that into their work. So, you know, I know that the eye is super glassy, it's like really smooth, and so that's going to be a very different texture than this glitter here or the skin tone. So after you've created that area for your pupil, I also want to use this color to create this like outline on the rim of the iris. So the iris is like the colored part of the eye. And then I'm also going to just be adding some along the lash line. So it's really like bumped up here. Let's see, right around here. There's so many colors in here, it's crazy. And then also just a little bit above here. So already we're getting some like beautiful mixtures just from the violet, like playing around with the turquoise, like light blue aqua underneath. Cool. Okay, so, you know, when I'm working with a color, I like to look around the whole piece and just kind of, you know, let my eye follow it, like almost like a map. So, you know, I also see some of that here in this area that we've mapped out. And so you don't want to press super, super hard where you can't even see underneath. I do want to build it up so, you know, you can see the difference between this really hard pressure and this one right here. So we're going to build up this color, this deep shadow color, in many different layers. Okay, and then I also have some of this color kind of here in the top left corner of the eyebrow. Okay, great. You guys ready for the next step? Cool. All right, awesome. Right, so there's like so much. Oh, I love color. There's so many beautiful colors in this piece. It's like so rich. So the next one I'm gonna go into is this like light aqua color, and this is gonna be for the iris. And so we're going to use like different pressures for this. So as you can see on the left side, there's a lot of highlights. So I do want to leave some of the white of the paper showing to achieve that, kind of bright highlight and let it look a little bit like it's glistening. And then on the right side, it's a kind of medium to dark value. So I'm gonna start out by just, trying to look at the shape that I have for my highlight. And leave the white of the paper. And then I'm going to come around and find, a medium. And I'm also going to, go right on top of my violet. So then we get another color mixture too. So I don't know if you can really see right there. So, the nice thing about colored pencils is you can layer them. So when you look really close, this is creating like a light kind of transparent layer of this aqua color right on top. And it's much darker without it. So yeah, just playing around and really paying attention to the way that the colors are mixing. And then also, bringing it just over the edge of the pupil. So you get like a more blurred kind of transition. It's not like a super harsh line. Escher was like all about harsh lines, and this is the opposite. So it's like really blurred and almost like dreamy, hazy kind of look. Yeah, and then just continuing to look for like where else that color shows up. Like that color is also right next to the iris, but it's just a much lighter value. So, I'm just going to press down super light and add that tint. So back to our color star, the tint is when you have a mixture of white with a color. So we have the white of the paper mixing with our color here. And then just on the outside rim of that, we have some aqua. So that is more of like a harder pressure. How's my pace? Am I going a little too fast for you guys? Okay, just like let me know if you want me to slow down a little bit. But yeah, it's already coming to life like pretty quickly. Highlights do a huge amount of justice in making something come to life. I also have some of this blue kind of coming into this highlight here. See these little areas where it bleeds in? And you can also use your finger if you wanted to, smudge it a little bit. Okay, so the next color that I see popping up. Is this lime green? So yeah, this green, it's also called chartreuse. Strange to see it along the bottom of the eyelid here. But yeah, it's running along the bottom of the eyelid. I see like a tint of it, so think of that like almost like, when you wear certain types of sunglasses and they totally change the warmth or the coolness of like what you see. So that's like a layer of green over there, and also kind of speckles of it inside the iris. So you can grab that one next. If you don't have a lime green, you can mix it. So again, lime green is going to be yellow with just a touch of blue. So that's pretty much touching right along where we like have this curve line here. Going along the bottom of the eyelid. You'll notice, the total difference between where it's white underneath and then where you get this violet underneath. So you get some color mixing there. And then there's this little, it looks like a little angle line here, kind of cutting in on the corner of the eye. And then, like I said, you can do a really light kind of, shading right over it as well. Okay, let's see. I'm trying to like let you guys see a little closer. Get a little closer here. So, yeah, see, there's so many colors that I can see here. So I followed along here. I'm going to add these specks of it right in there. There's some green, like look at that little hint of green up against the purple that we have. And then it's even like kind of speckled along other areas inside the piece. So there's like a really great use. The artist does a really great job of like moving your eye around the piece, which is something we've talked about before, making the viewer, like controlling the viewer's like kind of gaze by putting certain colors in certain areas. Okay, so I'm just gonna keep adding that. It's starting to look like Avatar, right? I love that movie. Wait, have you guys seen Avatar? Oh no. Oh my gosh, Lily. Well, ask your
Coming out the second one soon, I think, right?
What did you say?
Aren't they coming out with like a second Avatar soon?
Oh yes, I cannot
Yeah.
wait. Yeah, a lot of people bagged on Avatar because like it doesn't have that interesting of a plot, but the colors alone, like the forest scenes, the artist that created that digital art, so cool. It was so funny when it came out in theaters. I went with my sister, but it was like the same time Avatar the Blue People came out, the same time that like Avatar, the little guy with like the arrow on his head came out, and we went to the wrong one. Like, And it was so funny because my sister the whole time was like, she thought we were gonna see the little dude, airbending and stuff, and then she was like, "What the heck? What are all these blue people?" So funny. Okay, yeah, so I'm just like adding it all over the place, and then you can also start bringing some of that green down here. So for now, I'm just going to do a really light kind of shading in the bottom left corner. And that's where we see, if you break it down, another like thing you can do to break it down, like break down the detail is just squint your eyes. And this is like a triangle of skin and like warmth down there, so I'm gonna map that out. Okay, cool. It's coming together. Okay, so I want to get a deeper blue. Right now it's feeling really like purple. So I see like a deeper blue here. And so if you have an ultramarine blue, it's a really great one. Oh, I need to sharpen mine. So yeah, I'm just going to start to add a layer of the ultramarine blue on top of the purple. Bring it a little bit cooler, a little more cooler. Right now it's a little too warm. And then I'm also going to have it right above here. So you see these little areas where the blue's kind of moving up. That's kind of her the eyes, the eyelashes here. So I'm always starting out with, these like more geometric shapes, and then from there, like adding more and more detail. Okay, so we're almost done with the cooler. Oh, almost forgot. There's a little pocket of that color up in the top right here. Then I want to kind of blend these two really different colors together. So right now it's a little harsh, the lines, but when you look really closely and when you look at eyes, there's so many like different curves, different specks. So we're gonna start to just bring in some of those details by adding some thin angled lines on the sides. Kind of going inward. But the real thing that really brings it all together is you can blend it by using white. So I know that, like, those of you that did the color star with me, we used white to add to our pigments to change the tint and like the tone of it. So white is going to really push everything back and make it kind of like smoother, which also helps make it look more like blurry. So after you've added some of these, lines for some of the detail in the iris, you can go on top with a layer of white. And obviously this is colored pencil, but when you get into paint, when you start adding, transparent or, different layers, you can use different types of materials, so like different mediums, to make something more transparent or more opaque. So this is going to be more opaque. So opaque is matte, M-A-T-T-E, matte. And it's the opposite of transparent. So yeah, then you can just use white, and the white really just like blends everything together. It's gonna get rid of those like hard lines. And it also just makes it like pretty glassy. And I'm also gonna use this white pretty much like over the entire eye. So also this little triangle over here on the side where we were blending a bunch of colors. The white is really going to, blend everything together. And let me zoom in to show you guys up close. So we have a really different texture here. So this is more of that raw, just, pencil straight on in thin layers. And then adding the white is going to really smooth everything out. You can also go over this highlight too, because even though we have the white of the paper, we want it to be like totally combined. Alright, we could like spend so much time just on the eye alone, but yeah, that really like creates this really glassy kind of effect. Let's see. I can also use this white, right down here, right underneath the green. I have this, minty green. And so if you just go on top of your blue with your white, it's going to kind of like change the color of it, and you can do these dots, so just circles, and then color them in to create this kind of sparkled effect. Okay, great. So, how much more time do you guys need for that step before we switch over to some of the warmer colors? You can just show me with your hands if you want. Oh, 1 minute. Lily, you're like the speedy Gonzalez. Yeah, 5 minutes? Okay, looks good, Spirit. Cool. you.
Thank you.
Oh, Lily, you could even start to, you know, like right now it's pretty hazy right here, pretty rough, and you can go on top with your white to start to add some of those opaque dots. Wow, I can't believe this is our last class. I like just checked my calendar, it's crazy. Before we finish, I'll show you guys, I'm pretty stoked about like next month's curriculum if you guys wanna join in again. So yeah, we can go over that at the end of class. So, let's see. We got about 30 minutes left. That's great. So, you know, now we can start to go into some of those warmer tones. So we're basically going to like be working in a very similar way where we're going to start with like a really light, pause my music really quick. We're going to start with like a really light application of our warmer colors. So it's a lot of like reds. See, like crimson red is a good one. Looks like this. Another good one would be like even some, this is called Tuscan red. So see some that are like a reddish brown over here. So you guys can just start to look at the colors that you see and try to like match it to the colors up here. So that's good practice for you guys to start training your eyes to be able to recognize the color. You can even like hold it up to your screen, you know, and try to see if it's like a pretty close match. And then like always, I always like to, you know, recommend having like a scrap paper. You can do a little like color swatch test to see what it looks like. And so the first one I'm gonna start out with is my crimson red. This one. So this is going to really change our piece. So, you know, you really want to be intentional like always. So think about, you know, the value. So this is like really light pink almost. So I'm barely going to be touching the paper in this section here that we have. And the nice thing is we've already started to like map it out. It does get a darker value. So I am going to, you know, create a little triangle shape there. Just to the left of the corner of the eye. So this is that darker value right there. So yeah, just look for some like geometric shapes. I'm going to bump up the contrast right above the blue. So we know that when you add red and blue together, you get purple. So that's going to bring us this deeper purple, almost like a plum color. And then I have another darker value kind of up around here. It becomes lighter in the middle and then gets darker up there. So I kind of have these little pockets of lighter areas that I've figured out. And now I can start to shade it. So again, just try to use the flat side, and it helps if you like hold it towards the bottom. Some artists even, you know, like hold it like this really loose, so you can like move your hand back and forth really quickly. So yeah, try that out and see what you think of it. It's kind of awkward at first, but definitely helps in like speeding up. And don't be afraid to go on top of colors. So, you know, this area is really dark, so I'm going to go on top with a layer of red. So that's why, you know, we did our color star before this, so that you guys could, you know, get to know the colors. And now we're just like putting it to use and seeing, you know, how our different colors interact. And if you wanted to even reference your color star, you could grab it if you have it on hand. Yeah, so this step is just like attacking your piece, like trying to get it in there as quickly as you can. And then you can slow down when you start to get to some of the, you know, details. Thank you. Great. So, really coming together. So once I finish with, you know, the kind of the darker areas, now I'm just going to let up a lot of pressure and then just, you know, try to add some of this kind of light pink. Yeah, and you guys can always rotate your piece too, you know, if it's easier to get to a certain area. This is also a good trick when you're not sure if like something's right, like just turning it can help you see the shapes differently. So if I'm checking, you know, like this is pretty sharp right here, so I'm gonna smooth that out. What else? This is pretty straight, it's actually more curved. So yeah, just like moving your piece and rotating it can help you see it. But yeah, I'll switch it back so I don't confuse you guys. Okay, how's everyone doing? Have any questions? Need help? What's up? Okay, so we got about 20 more minutes. Yeah, we're doing good pace. Yeah, good job so far. Let's see. Whenever you're done, you can just start to add some of those like highlights. So right now it's like pretty graphic the way it's mapped out, but if you just start adding your white on top, like there's tons of little like sparkles in here. And this is really just you know, playing around with texture. So like there's really bright highlights kind of in the inner corner of the eye, and then they get a little bit more of a light medium here. So just kind of changing your pressure. So, you know, hard pressure for the light highlights and then letting it up a little bit. So yeah, I mean, I'm pretty much just like repeating myself. But yeah, that's basically like what I think about when I'm approaching a drawing like this one. Yeah.